Let's see what kind of new things Melon Sandbox has in store for us today. That is freaking Darth Maul. Oh yeah, there he is. Let's see him. Boom. Oh, you never thought you'd see Fruit Maul. I'm a little sad to say I don't have a lightsaber. What can we give him? Oh yeah, that'll work. You might ask, what's that stuff that's on there? Well, Darth Maul loves himself an apple, and he's been slicing up some apple in order to get the appropriate size that he needs. And okay, how is this apple still standing? Don't you know who this is? Fruit Maul takes no prisoners, okay? Oh, geez. Anyway, we got some really awesome mods today. I think you're gonna really like them. This epic guy is the Hermit Watermelon. Look at him. Oh, yeah. He likes to live on his own, and he's quite the master of the bladed weaponry. And this is Corn. Hello, Mr. Corn. He needs to shuck you. You know what I mean? Like, literally take and kind of scrape that outer layer off. Okay, that is totally unintended. Oh no. That's the best way to deal with Corn, apparently. There you go. Now that he's down, now we can easily get the rest of that, those kernels out of there. There we go. That's the first part we need. Now to make some popcorn. Oh, back up a little bit. Oh geez, he's okay. Don't worry. Don't look at him. Just watch the popcorn popping. There's no, what the heck? Where's the popcorn at? We need some more popcorn over here. Wow, the fire is still burning. Drag him. There we go. Yeah, look, there's the popcorn. Oh yeah, that's nice and tasty. We need some butter. You know, it's one thing that I really wish this game had, the ability to just like go through the mod list and find whatever weapon and things that you want, because I know there's probably a lot of weapons in here that I don't have that I really desperately need. It's freaking Jack Sparrow. Look at him. And this is a gooseberry. I don't know what a gooseberry is. What the heck is a gooseberry? Oh, I looked it up. They're really weird looking. I would never eat one if I found it in the wild, but apparently you can't eat. Anyway, this one shot is not meant for you, gooseberry man. It's meant for Captain Balbosa. You know what I mean? Anyway, look, dude, I can't believe how good this looks. Somebody literally went through and made every pixel of this guy. Okay, Mr. Gooseberry, here's your shot. I think we got it. I think we got him. That's what gooseberry juices looks like. This is just a fruit game, okay? So, you know, the violence that you're seeing is literally just me getting ready to eat, okay? So let's go ahead and let's, there you go. Nice. Now we peel the front. Now we need to peel the butt. And then just, oh, pick it up, please. Thank you. And, oh, he had two shots the whole time. Actually, he had three. Dude, why is the gun looking like that? Where it like comes down. What the heck? It's so weird. Did you see that? Look at this. What's that reload? That doesn't make any sense, Jack. And how do you have a shotgun?
I'm sick of all these kids always all up in my yard and messing with my plants and stuff and pooping everywhere.
You might ask yourself, old grandpa man, what do you mean by pooping everywhere? Well, you see, the kids that are playing in his yard are little tiny Viking penguins. Look at them. They're so cute, little Viking penguins. I want one as a pet or just like a stuffed animal to get to my kids. Anyway, the Viking penguins are here, and this old man's mad, and he's like, get out of here, little penguins. Get out of here. Oh, but then little did he know that the Viking penguins actually have little metal helmets, and as you can see, that's what happens to watermelons when you mix metal and make some metal happen. Okay, let's see. I want that to happen again. I don't even know how it occurred. Oh, there it is again. Oh, the old man. Oh, okay, Viking penguins. Oh no, eating some watermelon. Yeah, this is so good. Just listen, juicy, juicy watermelon. You didn't know penguins like the watermelon, did you? Don't mess with this watermelon. This is a normal watermelon from the streets over here. Look at him thugging it out. He's like, yeah, you know what I'm saying? Welcome to my hood over here. This is a normal ordinary watermelon. And this is not. This weird looking gangly nose chin creature over here is actually Loki, I guess. Loki, the goblin watermelon, apparently. I know what Loki looks like, and I don't think he looks like this. Anyway, maybe like the comic book version did. Look at his little arm things and stuff. He's got all these hooks and stuff. I mean, he's like, you know, mischief. Kind of looks like a jester. Let's see if he's got any magical powers. Look, I can activate him, like something. He should have something. He does have this. Just imagine this one over here, and stuck to him. It did. There he goes. Yeah, that's what he's got. Oh, jeez. Hey, I've never used that before. That was pretty violent. I think Loki needs a couple on him, if you know what I'm saying. Here's how we do it. We pause the game. We spawn a bunch in, like this. Okay, and if it worked the same way that the other one did. All I should have to do is activate them. Yep, there we go. Oh yeah. The beep makes it even more ominous and amazing. Here we go. Should we follow Loki's head? Let's do it. There you go, and here we go. Let's see, oh my gosh. Oh! Whoa, okay now, dude, we blew Loki right out of his body. Look at this. I think we can stop following him now. Wow, look at this, like a foot or something. There's just pieces of him everywhere. That was quite insane. I want to do that again. This time we're gonna just zoom out a little bit so we can really see this happen. Here we go. Oh, I like how they stick to him. It's beautiful. He literally just disintegrated, and then some parts fell down. Man, this is the ultimate cactus. Some kind of like fighter looking cactus. He's geared out. He even has like crazy looking knee pads and boots and stuff. He's quite insane. Today, he's fighting off against a brand new monster, which I'm so excited about because the game needs more monsters. Every time, there needs to be a new one. And this one, though, is on a whole different level. Look at this. It's a Minotaur. Woo, man. He's got some horns. Crazy looking hand thing. They do move. Listen to him. He's got like stone sounding hoof things going on. Oh, he's already. Oh, he means business. Look at this tail. He's got a tail here. Yeah, he means some serious business over here. He's like Bronco style. Now, the question is, can we take the horn and put it through the cactus? My guess is no, because usually when we try to do this, it doesn't work. Whoa! He straight up flung him around, though, which is pretty cool. We need to take a body. Like, let's just use, what can we use for a chicken? Yeah, there we go. Chicken boy. We're gonna use the chicken, and we're gonna try to drop him, okay? We're gonna drop him. We're gonna go straight up. We're gonna just drop him right on him. Usually when we do this, it doesn't work, you know? It doesn't do anything when we impale, but I wonder if we drop him. How are we missing that? How was he not lined up? He was perfectly lined up. He did it perfectly. Okay, one, two, right there. Three! Dude, he straight up hit him, but he's okay. That's unfortunate. So we need to figure out a different way to do this. All right, the only way that I can think to do this is to just get him down like this, and then... Yeah, well, he destroyed the chicken and his neck. His own neck. Oh my gosh. It's not his neck, actually. It's like his... Oh, it's his, like, chest from, like, the, you know, top of the rib cage. Oh, the sternum area. I mean, he's a Minotaur. I don't know if they have that. But look at everything is very loose on him. That's very unfortunate. Okay, it worked. Totally worked, okay? Don't look at anything else. It's fine. I'll make your weird animals over here. I hope you enjoyed watching. Let me know what you think of the new stuff. Okay, he's farting on him. All right, bye.